Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining us here on Horizon. I'm Rob McClendon. So what do you want to be when you grow up? Not an uncommon question for most young people, but one that can often bring just a perplexed look. But what if the problem does not lie with the lack of an answer, but with our question? Maybe what we should be asking is, what fascinates you? Or even better, what do you want to know more about? Which is what the organizers of a camp called STEAM Maker hope to help students and teachers find with hands-on education.
Think back on your time in the classroom. Most of us can dig up at least one memory of a lecture that bored even the teacher giving it, accompanied by restless and sometimes defiant students. This is a scene that we may soon see evaporate in a puff of steam.
Okay. Not loud enough.
So you guys selected this.
The most well-known definition is science, technology, engineering, arts, and mathematics. And it's a combination of bringing these content pieces together where it can mimic more the real world.
Ginger Lumen teaches and advocates for this model of classroom instruction.
So you take things totally apart.
Where learning is guided by curiosity.
We believe in the tinkering, the making aspect of learning, of fun. You know, so long school has been sitting at a table and doing worksheets, and there's a huge movement now of, let's get a lot more active in the classroom, where all levels of kids can really find true engagement and interest.
That is why these students and teachers have all gathered in Enid, Oklahoma's Waller Middle School. Oklahoma CareerTech's Jeremy Zweiker.
So this camp is actually funded through Carl Perkins, which is a piece of legislation at the federal level that gives states money for career and technical education. From the outside looking in, it's going to look like a really cool summer camp for kids, bringing students in and giving them the opportunity to learn and learn in a way that they might not normally learn through maker education. And inside looking out, it's teacher professional development. And so we're working with the teachers, the instructors, on how to do project-based learning.
Oh my goodness, it helps so much to do this so that I can help troubleshoot problems in the classroom. So when they have a problem, instead of saying, well, you need to look at the help screen or you need to, you know, Google it, then I can at least go through the process.
Ronnie Harrell is here discovering new ways she can guide her middle school math students through technologies that have already captured their interest, like coding for apps.
After sitting down and using the coding program instead of just watching the kids do it, I can see how I can tie sequencing and patterning and different things like that in using the coding programs. Maybe it's going to look messy, but sometimes learning is messy, and so I'm okay with that.
Coding is just one of the stations at this week's camp. There is also 3D printing, music, wearable technology, and that's just the beginning.
One of the things that we're doing is called autopsy and reconstruction, where people get to take apart everyday objects and autopsy, analyze, what is this? How are these screws? How's it held together? What's the power source? What makes it do its thing? And then they get to reconstruct several different devices into a new awesome Frankenstein character. And so yesterday, the very first one we had, this camp, they brought one of those speak and say, you know, it has the switch and it turns and says, the cow says moo. And they took the sound card to that, the sound card, and put it to a subwoofer that they had reconstructed now that this is really loud.
The car says.
They said, this would be a great toy for kids who have learning disabilities or hearing disabilities. And I thought, what imaginations are getting developed here?
Imaginations like that of Reuben Daniels.
I hope it just kind of like gives me something fun to do, but at the same time something that I'm actually like learning from and creating something and actually like doing something instead of sitting around like playing on my phone or something like that.
When I spoke with Reuben, he was designing a project for the 3D printer.
When you mess up and then you go back and fix it, you're like one step ahead, so then you go back and you can go a step or two further before you like mess up again, and then you can go back and fix it, and it just helps progress you through the process.
But when we first spoke, he was at the Stomp Rocket station.
You just like trial and error until you figure out like how to make it fly straight and like just all those different things, make sure it's not leaking air anywhere.
Trial and error, and then trying again. That is the point of STEAM.
So much in life and school is about keeping kids safe. It's about making sure that they don't make mistakes, because as parents and as teachers, it breaks our heart to see them disappointed. But really, in the real world, that's where we learn and grow. It's where we experience some sort of failure and then have the opportunity to recover. And I want to do that more in school with kids, because there's so many kids right now where we're telling them how they're wrong, slow, weak, and stupid. And they're not. They just don't memorize well, or they aren't strong readers because of some sort of disability. Likewise, we have kids who are really brilliant and who are great at memorizing, but how many of us know kids who, when they get out into the real world, they fall flat on their faces because there's nobody there telling them what to, when to, how to? It breaks my heart too, just as much. And when they start to get hands-on where they can see and feel and touch and experience, the light bulbs, they don't come on, they explode.
Creating independent learners, thinkers, and doers, all through a little STEAM.
Now, one of the goals of the federal program that helps fund the STEAM Maker Camp is to direct students to non-traditional careers like female firefighters or male nurses, all in an effort to strengthen our workforce with more diverse backgrounds. Now, when we return, we visit a coding camp.